Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm gonna be doing 20 beauty hacks that I think every girl should know. Obviously, if you watch a lot of these videos, you're gonna know some of these, but hopefully you do learn something new. I love watching these. These are like my guilty pleasures. So hopefully you guys learn some new tips and tricks. Like always, if you wanna be friends with me, subscribe down below and give this video a thumbs up. And let's just get right into the hack. The hack number one is to use tape for your eyeshadow and your eyeliner. This will just give your eyeliner and your eyeshadow that straight Instagram looking edge that you always see without having to take a makeup wipe or anything to it later. If you just line up the tape from your bottom lash line to the bottom of your brow, you will get a perfectly straight line every single time, and it also helps if you're having trouble with winged liner. Hack number two is to set your eyeliner with black eyeshadow or the color eyeshadow that matches with your eyeliner. This just helps it to not smudge, especially with those toe liners that tend to smudge throughout the day. Hack number three is to use a card when applying mascara. You just place the card on top of the eyelashes, and this just helps the mascara not to smudge onto your lid. Hack number four is to highlight your lips to make them appear bigger. By highlighting, you're bringing the top of your lips out, while in contouring, you're making things sink in. I mostly highlight my Cupid's bow and just the very edge of my lips just to bring out my upper lip and to make my lips seem bigger. Hack number five is to use red lipstick to conceal under eye circles. If you have really dark under eyes and normal concealer just isn't doing it for you, apply red lipstick right underneath your eyes and then apply your favorite concealer over the top, and it'll help your eyes appear brighter and it'll get rid of the darkness that you have underneath your eyes. Hack number six is to line the outside of your lips with a darker color to make them appear bigger. Hack number seven is to use foundation over your lips before you apply lipstick to make your lipstick more true to color and a lot brighter. Hack number eight, if your favorite lipstick is glossy and you want it to be matte, just apply any powder over your lips and it'll give it that matte look. Hack number nine is to use your powder highlight that you normally use on your face to highlight your collarbone area, your shoulders, and the shins of your lids in order to make them seem more glowy and healthy and moisturized. Hack number 10 is to use a spoon instead of your finger in order to remove the excess lipstick. Most people use their finger for getting off the excess lipstick so that it doesn't go on their teeth, but really you're just getting more makeup product on your finger and it's not getting all around the edges. So if you use a spoon, you're more likely to get more of that excess lipstick and you're not getting your hands all dirty with makeup. Hack number 11, if you have puffy eyes, just put a spoon into the freezer for about 15 minutes, or you know, you can do it overnight, and then place it underneath your eye until it's no longer cold. And what this does is increase the circulation underneath your eyes, and it gets rid of the puffiness. So, win-win. Hack number 12 is for my girls that have really ashy skin like I do. My sister's boyfriend's dad is a doctor, and he told me this, and it really works. If you put on lotion 15 minutes before you go into the shower, and then you go take your shower and you put on lotion after, putting on the lotion before you even go into the shower really helps the lotion soak into your skin, and so it'll actually help the lotion that you put in after your shower soak in even better. So if lotion right after your shower just isn't cutting it for you, try this and it will actually help your skin feel a lot more moisturized and less ash. So hack number 13, if you have really frizzy hair like your homegirl, use a t-shirt instead of a towel to dry your hair, and it'll actually help get rid of the frizz, because when you're using a towel, you're like shaking up your hair with the towel, and a t-shirt is just a lot more gentle to your hair, but it still will soak up that water in your hair. So, t-shirt, not towel. Hack number 14 is to rinse your hair with cold water. So warm water actually will open up your hair's cuticle and it lets the shampoo and conditioner moisturize your hair and do its job. But at the end, cold water actually helps to close the hair's cuticle to seal in all of that moisture. So instead of rinsing out your shampoo and conditioner with warm water, try doing it with cold water so that all that shampoo and conditioner can really do its job. Hack number 15, if you absolutely must dry shave your legs, Don't do it with body wash, do it with lotion. Body wash just strips your lids of all their moisture and leaves them feeling dry, where lotion will actually help moisturize your lids and leave them feeling fresh and good. Hack number 16, if you are in a rush and do not have time to iron your shirt and it's all wrinkly, use a straightening iron instead to actually flat out those wrinkles while the shirt is on, and it's just as effective as ironing your clothes. Hack number 17 is to take a powder brush and a bobby pin and put the bobby pin into the base of the powder brush in order to create a DIY fan brush. Hack number 18 is to let your perfume air dry instead of rubbing your wrists together. When you rub your wrists together after applying perfume, you're actually weakening the scent and changing the scent of your perfume, so it might not smell the same as when you just spray it directly out of the bottle. So instead, just let your wrists air dry and the perfume will take care of the rest. Hack number 19 is to use coconut oil and dish detergent to get rid of the stains on your beauty blender. I know for me, I'll clean my beauty blender with the actual beauty blender cleaner, but the stains do not go away, and it's the most irritating thing for me because I'll buy cute purple beauty blender and it looks brown. It's so gross. So just equally apply coconut oil and dish detergent to the beauty blender to get rid of these stains. And lastly, hack number 20 is to spray hairspray directly onto your brush to get rid of flyaways. I know a lot of people tend to apply the hairspray directly to their hair and then brush it, but if you apply it right to the brush, it'll make sure that you're not using too much excess hairspray to get rid of your flyaways, and it'll leave your hair not feeling sticky but still sleek. Okay, so that's it for this video today. I hope you guys all enjoyed it. If you did, please subscribe down below and give this video a thumbs up. And I'll see you guys all in my next video. Bye, guys! Okay, so that's it for this video today. I hope you guys all liked it and learned something new. If you did, please subscribe to my channel down below and give this video a thumbs up. And I'll see you guys all in my next video. Bye, guys! Okay, so that's it for this video today. I hope you guys all enjoyed it and learned something new. If you did, please subscribe to my channel down below and give this video a thumbs up. And I'll see you guys all in my next video. Bye, guys!